Hi, welcome to a product tutorial from Robojax. My name is Ahmad Shamshiri. I'm presenting this tutorial from Canada. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how these lithium battery cell balancer work. I'm going to show you the schematic of this, how this functions. I'm going to connect it to the battery, and also I'm going to practically show you how this does the balancing on this battery, and also this can be used for these type of batteries as well. Let's get started with this. Current will start draining. And here, this is as if we have a switch, A3A. And after that, we have this here battery. And also, the battery is 8 cell. This connector will be negative of cell 2, will be connected to the positive. Voltage is here, and the current is here. Let's get started with this. For all these lithium ion or lithium polymer batteries, you need to keep them balanced, and to keep them healthy and to give them longer life, you need to balance them. Majority of the chargers that you buy for these lithium batteries, they have cell balancer. This portion is for balancing the cells. This is for 3 cell, and we have 3 balancer here, 1, 2, and then 3. I have separate video explaining this 3 cell charger and balancer. The link for that video is below this video in the description. But these are also sold separately for the purpose of just balancing. For example, this is for a 4 cell balancer, as you can see here, B4. And this is for 3, because we have 3 balancer here. And then we have, as you can see, more. There is 5. This portion is empty, so we have 5 balancer, 6 balancer, and also 8 cell balancer. You might see them something like this in red color, but these are exactly the same chip, but they put different value of resistor to balance it at different rate. To explain this balancer, we have a balancing chip, we have a MOSFET or a transistor switch, and we have a resistor. This balancer will check the voltage of the battery continuously, and if it is above certain value, depending on the type of the battery, it will connect this resistor at the 2 terminals of the battery and will drain the battery here and dissipate the power as heat. So the battery will slowly, the voltage of the battery will slowly be decreased. This is one of the famous cell balancer chip. The one that I'm using is BB3A. And this version is written on the chip. Actually, this is a variation of this HY2213. And as you can see here, they have different version. If you get the AB3B, that will be for this type of battery, which is 4.2, but the release voltage is different. And here you can get also 4.18. Depending on the different chemistry of the battery, you will put different model. But for all these batteries that you buy, we will be using BB3A, which works with 4.2 volts. So what it does is that the cell balancing will start at 4.2 volts, and there is some 25 millivolts variation, plus minus, up and down. But at 4.2 volts, it will start activating the balancer. And when the voltage drops, again, it will stop it at 4.19. And here is the schematic for HY2213. This pin is connected to the battery. So this is the battery. The battery is connected to this terminal. The positive is on this side. For each battery, we have the same circuitry. And this pin, via pin 2, via this resistor, it is connected to the battery. It measures the voltage. It needs very little energy, like microampere, to measure the voltage. And when the voltage goes above 4.2 volts, then it will, via pin 6, it will turn on this MOSFET, which is connected via this resistor between the positive and the negative of this. When this is switched on, these 2 terminals will be connected, and this resistor is connected on 1 positive of the battery, and the other side of the resistor will be connected to the negative, and the current will start draining. And here, this is as if we have a switch and a resistor across this battery, and when you turn the switch on, it will connect this resistor and the 2 terminals, and the current will start flowing. So The amount of current depends on this resistor, which will turn on when the battery reaches at 4.2 volts. So you can see this is a 62 ohm, this 62, and then 0 means no value. If there is 1, it will be 10. So now this is 62 ohm resistor, and here on this one we have 100 ohm, this is 101, this 1 means 10, so there is a value, 100 ohm. And here on this module we have 43 ohm resistor for this 4 cell. So we can calculate amount of current, 4.2 divided by 62 ohm resistor. And as you can see, it says 67.7 milliampere or 0.067 ampere. The main component is BB3A. And after that, we have this A2SHB. This is a MOSFET. And then we have the resistor, which you see it large here on this side. And here is a data sheet for the A2SBH. The actual model is this one, but on device marketing is as A2SHB. And this is a MOSFET that can handle up to 3.7 ampere. The resistance of drain source is 50 milliohm when it is turned on. That is this MOSFET. And here is a battery charger and balancer where you can connect your battery, and also you can connect all the connectors where just GSTXH connector. For example, here you can connect a 2-cell which has 3 wires and 3-cell which has 4 wires, 4 and more cells. And on this one, when you select the type of battery, let's say lithium ion, you can see that it has balance feature. Once you press the balance, then it will tell you the balance current, at what current you want to balance it, because it will create that current. And here it will tell you how many cells you have. For example, 3-cell, you can go for 4-cell. And once you start, it will balance your battery. And this IMAX B6A is also another charger which you can connect it to AC anywhere in the world, and it can balance the different type of batteries, including lithium phosphate, lithium polymer, lithium ion, nickel cadmium. Any type of battery that you want, it can do the charge, discharge, and balancing. And here I have some lithium polymer batteries. This is bad now, but I'm going to show you using this battery tester. This can be also purchased from eBay and AliExpress or Amazon. I have a video explaining this. You can check the battery, the lithium batteries, with this. And if I insert it, it shows the total voltage, and then each cell, it shows that all is 11, and cell number 1, 3.6, cell number 2, 3.6, and 3.7, and all. So it continuously shows you each cell. And if the battery is 8 cell, this connector will be long, it can measure up to 8 cells. And here if I check the other battery, you will see that it shows all 11 volts. So first cell is low, 2.8, 4.1. It's a 3-cell, 2200 milliampere hour. All 11.9, the first one is 3.9, 3.954, and this is a brand new, never used battery. (Beep) 11.2, 3.69, as you can see, 7, 6, 9, and 7, so this is fully balanced. You can use these pieces separately only once the battery is fully charged, so you can use it to balance it. If the battery voltage is below the threshold of this balancer, it will do nothing. If you connect this right now to this module, nothing will happen because the voltage is below 4.2 volts. And here how to prepare it. This is for 4-cell. As you can see, this is all filled up, and this is for 3-cell. The last portion is empty. And here we will connect the first cell, the negative here, the positive here, And then the second cell, the negative will be here and the positive at this point. And the third cell, the negative will be here and the positive will be in that cell. So I've soldered all these wires, which will be soldered to the batteries at these terminals here and here. And here is how you prepare your battery before connecting your balancer. The negative of first cell is battery 0 or 0 volts, and the positive is 3.7 volts or B1. And then you connect another battery, the negative of cell 2 will be connected to the positive of cell 1, and the positive is to the point of B2, and it is 7.4 volts. And then the third cell will be connected from the negative to the positive. If you pay attention, they're all negative to positive, so they are in series to add up the voltage. So cell 3, the negative is at this point, and the positive is battery 3 or battery plus, and 11.1 volt. Now, to connect it with a cell balancer, you will connect from the positive to B1, and it will balance only one cell. But if you have second cell, continue from the second point from B2, also connected here to B2. And if you have the third cell, connect the positive of the last cell to B3, and this way it will balance them all. And here for demonstration, I'm using my power supply as a battery, and currently let's assume the battery voltage is 4 volts. And the positive terminal is connected here, the negative is connected here. Now I'm just balancing one cell. And here I've put also my ammeter in series to the one cell so we can see the current here. The voltage is here and the current is here. And now I'm increasing the voltage slowly. You will see the voltage as it reaches around 4.2 plus minus 25 millivolts. The current will pass, and on this module, this MOSFET will turn on and connect this 62 ohm resistor across the battery, which has now this voltage. And when you turn the switch on, it will connect this resistor and the two terminal, and the current will start flowing. So I'm increasing the voltage. Pay attention here. As you can see, 4.1 volt, there is no current, 4.11, and as you can see, 4.17 also, 4.2, and slowly it's showing up, 4.22. As soon as it goes like 10 millivolts more, now it's 4.23, and you can see that we have 66 milliampere across the battery. So this way, now this 66 milliampere will take a while to reduce the level of the voltage from the battery. So I'm increasing the voltage. Pay attention here. As you can see, 4.1 volt, there is no current, 4.11. As you can see, 4.17 also, 4.2, and slowly it's showing up, 4.22. As soon as it goes like 10 millivolts more, now it's 4.23, and you can see that we have 66 milliampere across the battery. So this way, now this 66 milliampere will take a while to reduce the level of the voltage from the battery. But keep in mind that when this is connected, you cannot have also a charger connected. You cannot have power across this connected when the balancer is connected. So when you connect the balance, the power should be turned off. That's why these chargers, they shut off, because we have a and balance controller, and also we have battery protection. This battery protection will turn off the external power, and this will kick in to balance it. If I increase the voltage, which in real life you will see that in real life, you will not be able to go to this high because the battery protection is preventing it, but the current will increase. And that was 66 millivolts, milliampere. And then if I reduce the voltage slowly, it will turn off, as you can see, even at this voltage. When the voltage goes back to normal, this will turn off. Here now I'm connecting this battery, which is already balanced, the voltage is very low, to just demonstrate that there is no current passing through this. And I've connected it, the voltage is 3.94, and the current is at the moment zero. Thank you for watching the review presented by Robojax. If you learned something and found this useful, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. If you want to get updates of my upcoming videos, you may subscribe now. Hi, welcome to Product Review by Robojax. My name is Ahmad Shamshiri. I'm presenting this tutorial from Canada. In this tutorial, we are going to do the review and see how we can use this 03962A LiPo battery or battery charger module of rated of 1 ampere. I'm going to explain the module, all the components, and showing you the schematic diagram. 056 chip, the pin VCC is connected to. Then I'm going to show you how to wire it and also charge the battery here or USB. And these are, I'm going to show you the amount of current that it can provide and charge the battery with an empty battery. Current at the moment to the battery. In this video, we're going to see how we can use this 3-cell labeled as 40 ampere lithium battery charger. These are all exactly the same with different shapes and different manufacturer. We're going to connect it to 3 18650 lithium batteries. Then I'm going to explain the module, all the inputs and outputs. Then I'm going to look at each component and try to bring up the data sheet. After that, I'm going to explain how to prepare the batteries and connect them together. Then I'm going to solder the BMS to the battery. After that, I'm going to measure the voltages across each cell. I'm going to charge it. What type of source you need? So I've set the current to 2 ampere here. Then we are going to apply charge to the batteries at different currents and check it. After that, I'm going to try to connect a load and discharge the battery and see how it behaves. I will also test the overcurrent protection, over voltage protection, and under voltage protection as well. And then we are going to do the short circuit protection by connecting the output of the battery short circuited. This is a very short video which will just show you how to connect the battery and start charging it and using it. If you need full detail and explanation how it works and all the components and different tests, I have a longer video. The link for that video is below this video in the description.